Anyway, what's this all about? Disgrace, dangerous, not a very edifying spectacle, wretched women.
Is this what? About women on panel shows?
Ah, yes. Only last year, in fact, I think. Horrified.
Yes, yeah. Been horrified yes. To be here.
So, panel shows, it's to do with games of some kind?
Is it women playing sport?
Yes, women doing sport. It was thought to be one of the most shocking things in the world. These are descriptions of the women's 800 metres at the 1928 Olympics, OK? So women had been allowed to compete in the track and field events for the very first time, and the media reported that it was a disaster. According to these reports, out of the 11 runners, 5 collapsed before getting to the end, 5 fainted at the finish line, and only one was still standing, and she passed out in the dressing room moments later. Some of the women took 15 minutes to regain consciousness. Those who hadn't won sobbed hysterically. And as a result, the 800 metres race was deemed to be just too injurious to these women, and it was dropped from the Olympics for 32 years. You can see here the German Lina Radke winning and Japan coming second.
She must have an early iPodding, because she's doing something.
In reality, there were 9 women runners. They all completed it. No one collapsed, no one became hysterical, and 6 of them beat the existing world record.
So, was this in the mainstream British press?
I know, it's shocking to think that the press might ever tell you something that's not...
Please don't tell me it was in the Murdoch papers.
This wasn't the first Olympics women competed in, though, was it? They'd competed before.
Only in some sports. So the founder of the modern Olympics, Pierre de Coubertin, he vehemently opposed female participation. He absolutely wasn't having it.
That's Rowan Atkinson.
He vehemently opposed female participation. He said it would be impractical, uninteresting, unaesthetic and improper. He said women's primary role should be to crown the victors, since they were, above all, a companion to men. But you're absolutely right. They had been allowed to compete from 1900, but only in 5 sports, and they were considered the kind of easy...
Sewing? Like...
Sewing, yes, was a big one. It was tennis, croquet, golf, sailing and equestrian. And the women got fed up with this. So in 1922, they held their own Olympics in Paris. 20,000 people attended. There were 18 world records set. One of the more unusual events is that one on the right, is the two-handed javelin. And athletes had to throw once with their right hand and then once with their left hand, and the score was the combined distance of the two.
So a sort of ambidextrous javelin.
Yes,
and then
yes,
your teammate had to catch it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to be the one who had to measure it when people were throwing the javelin left-handed.
It's one of the great incentives.
That's getting the javelin and throwing. I would have thought.
I would think it was quite tricky. Yeah.
I think she's going too far up that one.
I think her credentials are
One of the reasons why women wanted to take part in the Olympics was the incredibly restricted clothing that they wore in the traditional games. So up until the mid-1900s, female swimmers had to wear blouses and bloomers in the pool. They used to play tennis in dresses that covered the ankle and multiple petticoats and corsets and so on, shoes with heels.
But I think that's why it took so long for women to get involved in sports, because I run and it's all about 2 bras.
Yeah.
Keeping... Nothing should move.
Because otherwise, honestly, take your eye out.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like giving tips out at race days, sometimes to middle-aged men, to be honest.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.